seeing her. Sharon Greck is here from Benjamin Moore. Man, are you popular?
Oh, I love it.
This is a really sweet set.
Isn't it fun?
This is all about the dinette.
The dinette.
Let's discuss what exactly a dinette is.
Well, it's funny because the definition is a small space, usually off the kitchen for informal dining. Mm-hmm. But in my mind, it's that sort of mid-century chrome, pleather, laminate set that you know, that are actually very popular. They're not cheap to get them in antique shops. So if you have one, hang on to it.
That's right.
But now I think it's becoming more of a trend with a lot of small spaces. Mm-hmm. For me, if I had the room in my house, I would create a dinette. Like, I would create this informal space. Because, you know, when you have not a lot of people over, or if it's just your family, you spend a long time, you know, in the holidays, and your bum gets a bit sore from sitting in the dining room chairs,
That's true.
So it's kind of nice to have a comfy area. So there's some really fantastic built-in banquette styles that I've been seeing. That's a big trend right now. And then in a small space, you've got storage under the seats.
That's true.
Very, very handy. But I thought, with all the modular furniture, the sectionals, and everything that's so key today, why not create your own little dinette?
Banquette. Yeah, that's smart. So
exactly.
You just use a piece of the sectional.
So this is a piece of a sectional, and that's the really cool thing. This is from Mobilia, and it can be a full size. Like, it could easily fill the size of my 10-foot wall.
Yes.
Or larger, because it all comes in individual pieces. But the way I use only three, so I've got two sort of slipper chairs without arms, and then I've got the corner piece. So it just creates this perfect little spot that you can sit. You can easily crowd three people around.
Yeah.
And then it gives you the space to put as many chairs or as few chairs. And on top of just having the sectional pieces, which again you could expand, in this small little cozy nook, I thought a round table would be perfect.
It works great. So, I mean, if you're the one in the middle, you don't want the arms because you want to be able to scooch out on both sides.
Exactly.
But if you're the one in the middle, you can be, all three of you can be eating at the table. And what we're doing now casually is we're sitting at our islands, right?
Exactly.
You don't necessarily want to be on a stool for a long time.
Well, that's it. It's a nice place to retire to, or if you do have a small space and you don't have room in the island, create something like this that's dual purpose. So I think that that's a really great trend. And as I said, I want to, like, I want one. I need a bigger house. So with the sort of tulip style and the Carrara marble, very classic.
Yeah.
And then the nice thing about that pedestal for the table when it's a small space is that you can put leggy chairs, you know, because it's not going to be too busy. So we got these really fantastic chairs also from Mobilia.
Nice color.
Isn't it a great color, Trace? And
love it.
Kind of has a nod to that retro feel that I was going for.
Yeah, absolutely.
So
there's also a lot going on the wall.
Yes, and it's pattern, right?
Yes.
And I think when you have a small space like this, you should not be afraid of color and pattern.
Yes.
So Kim showed a fantastic color early on. I'm going to be stealing that one soon. But here I used Fairmont Green, and this is actually from the historical palette.
Nice.
But it had a lot of vibrancy. So I picked up some of the patterns from the cushions and then found this really cool product. It's a stenciled masking tape that comes in a roll, and it's called Surface Motif from Peacock Living, a Canadian company. And this is how I created it. Now, you've got so many different ways that you can customize your patterns with it. And in fact, I've got a few that I can show you on screen in rooms where you can see the different patterns. So same product. This is a nice little preppy stripe, something very simple.
I like that.
And then we've got something a little more elaborate with the chevron, bolder colors. And the nice thing with this, as opposed to wallpaper, is you can customize the colors however you want. So here, I'm going to show you a little bit later how to do this, how to create whatever pattern you want. But again, it's building a space that has pattern and color and style, and you always need artwork to finish it.
So the artwork here, I love it. I think that, you know, it's just a nod to whatever area you're living in. This happens to be Toronto. But how is that made?
Well, this is a very talented artist, friend of mine, Emmanuel Pavel, and he actually creates this not with paint, but with tape. Household tape. Every little line on there is made with tape.
That is so cool.
Masking tape, duct tape, automotive tape. I'm sure there's some hockey tape on there somewhere.
Wow.
So just really working with all of the different colors of tape and then coating it with resin so that it stays intact. So beautiful, beautiful street scenes.
Yeah.
And I thought it was just a great way between the masking tape stencil and the tape art. I think we're on to a new trend.
You can have a whole tape house.
You can have a whole tape house.
I don't even know how he came up with that.
You know what?
That is very cool.
He is so creative. And to take something so utilitarian like that and turn it into something beautiful, I think is really
That's true art right there.
Spot on.